Today I wanted to talk about Legendary Celica and Thrasir, since with the recent monthly banner I was able to get both of them. I never got Thrasir before, and both her and Legendary Celica are two extremely fast, high damaging Green Infantry Mages. They are quite similar units, but there are some key differences between the ways they work in battle, and I wanted to share my thoughts on how they compare with each other. I won't be talking for this whole video. The first half will be a short comparison between Celica and Thrasir and what each bring to the table, then in the second half I'll have some fun gameplay of each in action. I was able to use Thrasir to beat Legendary Celica's Infernal map, and then I used Celica to beat Thrasir's Infernal map. This will not be a who's better type of discussion, but rather a fun look at both of these really strong mages. First, this is a brief overview of what each unit has in their base kits. Legendary Celica has 40 HP, 38 attack, 38 speed, 18 defense, and 28 resistance. Compare that to Thrasir's 40 HP, 33 attack, 39 speed, 23 defense, and 27 resistance. Similar HP, speed, and resistance, and Celica throws everything into attack while Thrasir puts those points into defense. She does actually make good use of those points. Besides both of their unique skills, which we will discuss more, Celica comes with Miracle, Swift Sparrow 3, and Attack and Speed Oath, pretty absurd when combined with her already great base attack and speed. As for Thrasir, she has Moonbow, Flashing Blade 4, and Panic Smoke, another great base kit for a high speed mage, and Thrasir can toss out Moonbows every fight if she doubles. Here is where our two mages start to differ a bit. Celica's Saintly Seraphim grants her +3 speed at all times, so she gets even faster. She will also deal true damage equal to 25% of the foe's res stat when initiating, allowing her to do at least some damage to even super high res units. She's not colorless like Legendary Alm, so this extra damage helps when dealing with red foes. As for Thrasir, Ifengir is effective against dragons, so that is real nice to have on hand. She will also gain +4 to all stats and neutralize effects that guarantee the foe's follow-ups, but only if she is within 3 spaces of an ally. Should she make an attack, she will then debuff the nearest allies with -4 to all stats. A bit selfish, but at least if Thrasir fights first, her allies can dispel the debuffs by moving around before the enemy phase. I've labeled the stat bonuses on screen to their base stats, and as you can see, Thrasir really starts to up her tankiness. She has part of no follow-up, which is great, and it's pretty easy to activate Ifengir, although her teammates are gonna suffer for it. Meanwhile, Celica brings the pain on the player phase, and she is a really scary attacker just from all the extra attack and speed she gets from Swift Sparrow. She'll also have a better time against any high-res tanks. We still need to look at their unique B skills, but so far it seems like Celica is pure player phase focused, while Thrasir at least has some enemy phase potential. Moving on to their unique B skills, Celica has Soul of Zofia, which basically combines No Follow-Up 3 and Desperation 3. Meanwhile, Thrasir has Killing Intent, which inflicts -5 speed and res on the enemy during combat if they start the fight with less than full health or if they have a penalty on them. Thrasir also gets a Desperation effect if she initiates combat, but she does not have to worry about her HP. Killing Intent just checks for the enemy's HP or a penalty. So both of these B skills are pretty dang powerful. Celica continues to be a player phase monster, and with no follow-up she stops skills like Quick Repulse while also neutralizing wary fighter type effects. This is really good with Desperation, because if she can get below 75% HP and she initiates combat, the only way to stop her from doubling twice in a row is to match her speed, and good luck with that. Thrasir is a similar story, but she can potentially use Desperation while at full HP. The stat debuffs on the enemy will stack with Ifengir, and at this point Thrasir is getting an additional 9 extra damage and creating a 9 speed difference in her favor. The catch is that her enemies need to be hurt or must have a debuff or status effect on them. Killing Intent is super strong, but it most likely requires setup from allies unless Thrasir is just cleaning up weakened foes. For Celica, her main weakness is that nothing in her base kit really helps get her into Desperation HP range. She has Swift Sparrow 3, which is awesome, but maybe Fury would have been more beneficial in situations where you need that Desperation effect. It's fine if you can set Celica up to survive her first round of combat, but if there's a really high physical attack enemy that can one-shot her, then that's not good. Basically, Legendary Celica is your typical Desperation user. She will have an incredibly strong player phase thanks to Saintly Seraphim and Swift Sparrow, but she's at her most powerful once Soul of Zofia's Desperation effect kicks in. At this point though, you need to protect her from any meaningful damage threats. Meanwhile, Thrasir has the potential to duel it out better, since she has higher defense and she gets extra defense and res, plus the ability to neutralize any follow-up skills from the enemy. However, Thrasir doesn't have the full power of no follow-up, so she is stopped by wary fighter type effects. She can get all the speed she wants, but if the enemy has wary fighter or something like Green Tonebreaker, she won't get that follow-up attack off, while Celica can push through no problem. One thing to consider is Flashing Blade, and it's important for both of these mages. Flashing Blade 4 adds 5 true damage on the hit, and since you ideally are doubling, that becomes 10 extra damage for a fight, plus a 2-turn special like Moonbow will proc on that second attack. Thrasir really uses Flashing Blade 4 well, since if she gets Killing Intent active, she can double tap enemies from the start, and despite her lower base attack, she's still gonna deal a ton of damage. For Celica, most players can probably use Flashing Blade 3 as a seal and she's still gonna do well, but losing 10 true damage potentially kinda sucks. Not to mention that with Swift Sparrow being a secret seal now, she can use that with along with Flashing Blade 4 and Moonbow and still get extra attack and speed even if it is a little bit less. I think for really high investment Legendary Celica builds, Flashing Blade 4 is just too juicy to pass up. 10 true damage on top of Saintly Seraphim's true damage is disgusting, and as long as you can survive that first counterattack, if the enemy does not match her speed, then the no follow-up effect will ensure Celica doubles. Bottom line is, both of these units are really powerful on the player phase. You can't put a Quick Repulse tank in front of them because they both neutralize Quick Repulse type effects. For Thrasir, if Killing Intent is activated, she can even end a unit's life before they get to retaliate, so you do need to be careful. Celica has to be in desperation range to do the same. Now, funnily enough, both of these ladies go down to Brave Weapon builds pretty handily, and we got two really powerful ones recently. Both Altina and Legendary Leaf will end Celica or Thrasir if they get to attack due to their dual phase Brave Weapons. Even on low health, the two of them can just use Vantage for easy pickings. As a bonus, Celica and Thrasir cannot use Hardy Bearing because that will then disable their Desperation effects. That's all I wanted to discuss. Now, you'll get to see these two in action. For both clears, I abuse Wings and Mercy Dancers because reinforcements are ridiculous. For Celica's clear, it's a pretty standard display of the power of a Desperation Mage and just her raw attack and speed. I even have a minus attack Bane one. For Thrasir, I needed to get Killing Intent active, so I called in the debuff expert, Mythic Yun, for some support. Yun really is an MVP for debuff based units, and she helps Thrasir fight at full strength. You'll also see Thrasir brawl it out with Celica because whoever gave her a pre-charged miracle special is just mean. Thanks for tuning in so far, hope you enjoy the gameplay.
Like this? I'm with you. Leave it to me. Of course. Like this?
Lead away.
I have hope. Like this? I shall stop you! I see. Leave it to me! I have hope.
Of course.
Like this? Leave it to me.
Choose your path.
I have hope.
I'll think about it.
Like this?
Yes.
Leave it to me. I have hope.
I'm with you.
Like this?
with you.
What?
Yes?
Why not?
All right.
What now?
Death is the end. What?
Let us go.
All right.
I am mystery. I see. I'm with you.
Death is the end.
Yes?
What?
Choose your path.
All right.
Why not?
Death is the end.
I see.
What?
What now?
All right.
It's your future.
Death is the end.
I'm with you.
What? Zah! Don't get in my way.
Let us go.
All right.
I am mystery.
Death is the end.
Choose your path.
Yes?
What?
What now?
Death is the end.